Growing Sunday from Skeynes Hill. We're in St. Augustine's Church. We have a thinned out congregation of six of us who are all on the team to assist with worship, all sitting at appropriate distances. This is a strange Sunday morning. Please bear with us, we are still working this technology out. Hopefully, you will have been sent by email a notice sheet, and in that notice sheet, you will have all your words. Please join in with the singing wherever you are. We will be singing here too. So I'm going to start with a prayer. A prayer for the National Day of Prayer and Action. Come, O Spirit of God, and make within us your dwelling place and home. May our darkness be dispelled by your light, and our troubles calmed by your peace. May all evil be redeemed by your love, all pain transformed through the suffering of Christ, and all dying glorified in his risen life. Amen. So shall we sing our first hymn, Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart. God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord fills the world and knows our every word and deed. Let us then open ourselves to the Lord and confess our sins in penitence and faith. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May the God of love and power forgive us and free us from our sins, heal and strengthen us by his Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ our Lord.
The first reading is taken from Psalm 127. Unless the Lord builds the house, the builders labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the guards stand watch in vain. In vain you rise up early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat, for he grants sleep to those he loves. Children are a heritage from the Lord, offspring a reward from him. Like arrows in the hands of a warrior are children born in one's youth. The second reading is from Colossians chapter 1. We always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you, because we have heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and love you have for God's people, the faith and love that spring from the hope stored up for you in heaven and about which you have already heard in the true message of the gospel that has come to you. In the same way, the gospel is bearing fruit and growing throughout the whole world, just as it has been doing among you since the day you heard it and truly understood God's grace. You learned it from Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is a faithful minister of Christ on our behalf. This is the word of the Lord.
Shall we sing our next hymn? All my days I will sing this song of gladness.
This morning is taken from Luke, so hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and the sword will pierce your own soul too." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Well, we live in challenging times, but this morning I'd just like to take you back to many years ago, to a land far away, where a maiden awaited her lover just recently returned from the wars. Her heart was heavy, for she was very sad, but her paramour brought a gift of hope, an elixir of life, a potion of delight, known in those days by the mystical name of Horlicks. If you know Horlicks, then you'll know what we're talking about. 9 months later, against all expectations, and certainly against all medical expectations as well, a baby boy was born. I was that baby, and my mother never tried Horlicks again. Now, not every couple are so fortunate, and my own family have been blessed by the miracle of IVF, but I rather like the thought that I was so wanted and loved right from the beginning. I was really blessed to grow up and to explore life in really interesting times, but then be able to go back to a home where I was safe and I was loved. So like me on Mother's Day, many of us will be grateful to our parents, and especially to our mothers, for providing that guidance and support so necessary for a good start in life. But today is also Mothering Sunday, and that is a day when our thoughts and our prayers as church communities traditionally turn towards our mother church. Now, for the older churches in this area of Sussex, that would probably have been Lewes Priory. That is, of course, before Thomas Cromwell and Henry VIII pulled it down brick by brick. So today, though, our mother church, we look to Chichester, the cathedral of our diocese. And we value the support and the guidance that institution gives us, especially in these difficult times. So today on Mother's Day, we give thanks and look back to where we as people have come from. And today on Mothering Sunday, we give thanks and look back to where we as a church have come from. So why is that important? I think it's important because roots are important. For where we have come from is important. Sadly, a dysfunctional childhood so often leads to a dysfunctional adulthood. And a dysfunctional church so often leads to a lost and disillusioned generation. Our background as children has a huge influence on who we become as adults, and the background of our faith has a huge influence on our future spiritual journey. So what about the role of the church, and specifically our church here, in the lives of our young people? What is the role? I've got 3 points to make. The first one is that safety is paramount. Children and vulnerable adults must know with absolute certainty that their church is a place of safety. We have a robust policy, and we must never let our standards slip. We want our children to look back at this church community as a safe place of love and care, a place where they in turn will want to bring their children. The second point is that there is more to it than just physical safety. It's about emotional safety too. Our church must be a place where our children can be allowed to grow up at their own pace and in their own way. I recall not many months ago, Lisa and Stephen's little boy Ross crawling up the carpet just at the side of our church here leading up to the communion. He was on the floor, he was pushing his toy car, he went up the steps, up to the communion rail, and where he was blessed by his mum, and I suspect the toy car was blessed as well. That was a very beautiful moment. But equally beautiful were the smiles and the love from the whole congregation as he made his way. We shared his joy, and we must never lose that. A third and final point. I'd like to mention spiritual safety as well. I recall hearing a very well-respected and lovely local man who claimed to become a Christian after hearing a sermon as a child, and that night waking up from a nightmare that he was going to hell. Let me say personally that if that is his memory of church, if it was accurate and correct, then that church was as guilty of a crime just as serious as any physical or emotional abuse. Perhaps we need to review our thinking and question how a God of love can be consistent with a God who delivers that sort of punishment to those who don't tick the right boxes and believe exactly the right things. So Mother's Day, Mothering Sunday, a day when we look back to the legacy we have received. But most importantly, we also look forward in faith to the legacy that we shall pass on. We have a responsibility to this and to the next generation to ensure it encounters in this place and in our lives a God of love, not a God of fear. So that when these youngsters look back to where they have come from, their memory is of a community which offered a glimpse of a God who provides a place of physical, emotional, and spiritual safety, and a God who loves them unconditionally for who they are. If we as a church can go some way to share that as our experience, as our faith, then they will look back with gratitude and recognition that who they have become, like us, depends a great deal upon where they came from. Amen.
Shall we stand to affirm our faith? Let us say together. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And shall we sing our next hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. kindness to us.
Creator God, thank you for the beautiful world you have made. Thank you for its constancy, for sunrise and sunset, the coming of spring with new plant and animal life around, and the way it provides for our needs, physical, emotional, and spiritual. But we know the world can be cruel in many different ways, and we pray today for those who are suffering loss, hunger, and instability made worse by climate change, driven by our human actions. Help us to take time to better understand the way we should live, so that there is enough for all, and we live in balance with the whole of your creation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, at this time when we are facing our own worries and anxieties about COVID-19, help us not to forget the enormous challenges of the poorest in this world. We particularly pray for the people of Zimbabwe, where an economic crisis and a harsh and unreliable climate mean that around half the population are currently going hungry. Thank you for the work of organisations like Tear Fund, who are supporting the most needy with food aid and training in farming techniques that work in extreme weather conditions. We pray for the success of Tear Fund's Easter appeal for the work there. Help us to show financial generosity where we can. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Sovereign God, we pray for the leaders in our country, for those in politics, in the health and social services, education, farming, business, industry, and banking. Give them strength and wisdom as they face the COVID-19 pandemic. Help them to provide wise and effective leadership that protects the most vulnerable and inspires us all to do what we can to address the day-to-day challenges we are facing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for the needs of our families, friends, and neighbours at this extraordinary time. For those who are suffering from COVID-19, for all those in isolation in the village, church, community, and parish, for all those who have either lost jobs or are anxious about losing them at this time, for young people as they struggle with the cancellation of their exams for which they have spent so long preparing, and for the abrupt way in which they have finished their time at school. For all those at St. Augustine's School, as they cope with closure and supporting the small number of children who will be in school. And for all of us as we adjust to completely new patterns of work and life. Help us all to put our trust in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Father, thank you that you have called us to live and serve as part of this community. At this difficult time for everyone, help our church family here in Skanes Hill to share your love through our words and actions. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I'd like to finish with the prayer for the week ahead, which is printed in this week's newsletter. We are not people of fear, we are people of courage. We are not people who protect our own safety, we are people who protect our neighbour's safety. We are not people of greed, we are people of generosity. We are your people, God, giving and loving, wherever we are, whatever it costs, for as long as it takes, wherever you call us. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Shall we continue in prayer and say the Lord's Prayer together? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Shall we sing our next hymn, Shine, Jesus, Shine? Notices. As you can imagine, we have a long list of notices. The first is, if you've got our St. Augustine's email, there is a lot of notices in this. Please read them. If you haven't got it by email, then tell Debbie if you would like it by email. Those of you that we know have not got email, Debbie is trying to drop them through your doors. So again, tell Debbie if you need a notice sheet and service sheet, because I think if this has worked, then we will do the same again next Sunday at 10. Next Sunday is, of course, our 90th birthday as a parish, so we'll try and make it a bit special from a distance. And maybe you'll just have to have your own cake and bubbles in your own homes. As far as wider details of notices, I'm afraid Easter flowers are cancelled. If you've paid money, then you'll get a refund in due course. The church will be open during the day for your quiet prayer. Please keep a distance from each other. Wash, sanitise your hands. If you've got things that are creative that you want to go into the newsletter, tell Debbie. I know Emily's been drawing some fabulous pictures for colouring, and we're going to get those out to you in different ways. Kairos is cancelled this evening. There is a hope to email you out some sort of short film, short thought, so watch your emails this afternoon for that. We are not going to do a healing and wholeness service next Sunday evening. Remember to light a candle in your window at 7 o'clock. Please take appropriate care with the live flame, but it's to tell the world that we are praying for them. If you would like a live stream evensong, then my husband James at St. Mary's Barkham will be live streaming evensong, and Debbie is telling me that she will be sending the link through on an email, and he will be lighting a candle at 7 as part of that. Practical notices, there is a village support system starting to get into place and starting to work. If you haven't again been part of knowing about that, ask Debbie or Jenny Walker. That's right, Debbie's prompting me from the other side of the church. Locally, up country are doing some delivery of things, food and things, and the farmers, the pub on the green, is turning into a shop, particularly to support the community. So there's details on our website or their website. Their website, or again, ask Debbie or our Facebook page. Okay, I think we're nearly there. Last notice, I think, is unfortunately we were going to have a celebration for the life of Joyce O'Leary on Thursday afternoon and inter her ashes. We will be interring her ashes, but privately with the family. Hopefully we'll get to celebrate later in the year and remember her, but please do not come on Thursday afternoon. I think that's all my notices. I'm looking around the room. Someone said thank you. And Steve and Helen. Yes, thank you. We had Steve, who's over in the corner, preaching. Helen, reading, praying. Tim, I don't know if you can see him. Has he just disappeared on the screen? You can see him. Tim on the piano. Thomas behind the tech. And Debbie as just general backup and being awesome. It's thanks to Debbie that this is really happening and you are getting notices and emails. She is working way over her hours, way over her hours. And thank you, Debbie, because without you, we couldn't have put this together. Okay, we have some Mother's Day prayers and a sending out. Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares for the care of mothers and all those who care for us. Thanks be to God for their patience when tested. Thanks be to God for their love when tired. Thanks be to God. For their hope when despairing. Thanks be to God. For their service without limit. Thanks be to God. Thank you, God, for all those who care for us. Thank you, God, for their love and concern. Thank you, God, for the joys they have shared with us. Thank you, God, for the pains they have borne for us. Thank you, God, for all that they give us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. May God who gave birth to all creation bless us. May God who became incarnate by an earthly mother bless us. May God who broods as a mother over her children bless us. May Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Now and forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. We have one more thing to say before you all go. The clocks go forward next week. Thank you, Thomas. Very important notice. And a lot of thank yous. Oh, and thank you to Keith, because Keith helped with the tech. Without Keith, we wouldn't have got the tech done. And thank you all of you at home that are listening. God bless you. And we will meet again next week, virtually online.